here we go. We are going to separate this transmission from this 3.0 and get in there and figure out which soft plugs have rusted out and caused the big leak. And right now what I have done is basically got the car up in the air, got some blocks under it, took the wheel off, it's outside. And the only thing I really did up here so far, of course, for you people who are just now watching this video, this is an intake plenum that I took off to find the leak and to replace the valve seals, not the valve seals, the valve gaskets and the lifters eventually over the next couple of days. But right now we're focusing on separating this transmission from this 3.0. And what I've done so far, I took the air cleaner out here, and there's a couple of screws. Let me get my light here real quick. A couple of screws there that hold the air cleaner in right there. I took that out and kind of chucked it off to the side. And there's a few hoses and some wires here. The water hoses you don't have to mess with because you can get into these top transmission bolts right under that exhaust there with an extension. If I shine that light right there on that bolt, you can see those bolts are pretty easy to get to. So a lot of this stuff on top you can do last. I will have to unhook the gear shift cable, and there's a couple plugs on the transmission. There's one right there I will get to once I pull that plastic cover off on the firewall, because that release clip is hidden on the other side of that plastic cover, that the inner fender. Once I take that off, I can get in there and release it without breaking it. And you got a couple of other smaller plugs, that reverse plug, and you got a couple of hoses there, transmission lines, which are pretty typical. You got to unhook those. And the transmission is an electric controlled solenoid transmission, is what I'm trying to say. I got to take that little 10 millimeter bolt loose there and pull the big plug out of the solenoid pack. And that's really all there is on top. And on the bottom in the back, there is a solenoid, a sensor for the crank sensor. It's down there. We'll show you where it's at here in a little bit. Once you unhook that, everything on the top is pretty much loose and ready to come loose. Now, I'm not going to go over every step of this, how to separate and get this transmission out of here. But most of it will be covered, and it'll be fairly straightforward, and you should be able to figure it out. Like I said, some of the wires and stuff, you just got to be careful and not break them. Now, what I've done here, I've taken the wheel off, and I went on ahead and loosened this a big nut up there that is an inch and quarter socket. And I'm actually using an impact wrench because I didn't feel like getting my breaker bar out tonight. And I've already got this loose. Take the pin out. Go ahead and take the nut off real quick. Might as well watch me, I guess. That out. Set that off to the side. And also, I have gone ahead and taken my caliper bolts out, back the brake caliper here. Get these out. Oops, I just dropped one somewhere on the floor. I heard it way in the back. They always roll away from me. Set that off to the side. Hopefully the lighting is sufficient. And now I can pull off my brake caliper. I need to get me one of those work lights where I can just kind of sit behind me and shine on everything. I'll pop this off. Set this out of the way for now. Take this hub off. Disc. Set it off the side. And now all I have to do is go over here on this side and go ahead and take off this tie rod end. Now, a lot of guys have issues. They have no problem breaking that bolt loose, but what they do, they break the bolt loose. And they actually break the bolt loose, and they get about halfway down, and they don't take the bolt all the way off, the nut, I should say, and the whole centerpiece starts to spin. So what you got to do is don't beat on this, don't hit it with a hammer just yet. Put some oil on there, take this nut completely off first, then go up here and hit on the top of this tie rod end, break it loose, and it should come out. That'll save you from having that entire unit spinning around, and it gets to be a real pain in the ass to get that off. So you don't want to get into a situation where you're going to spend 25, 30 minutes just trying to get that nut off. Then after we get that off, we just got to get down here in the bottom and take off this nut here, which holds the lower ball joint on, and get a pry bar, pry down on the bottom lower control arm, pull this unit out, and go ahead and take the axle out. Now, something else I did, I almost forgot to mention, I did go ahead and drain the transmission fluid out of the bottom of the transmission, because you cannot pull those axles out on this transmission without getting a bath. So trust me, it's worth about 20 minutes get all those little bolts out of there and drain that fluid, and it will make your day a lot less messier. And by the way, my transmission fluid is back there in the back in a pail. I don't think you can even see it. Back here somewhere. It's all back here out of the way. So the transmission has been drained of fluid. So now I'm going to go ahead, spray that nut on the tie rod end, take that off, and we'll go ahead and take this lower control arm off. And this axle is out. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to take the other side of the axle off, the passenger side yet. Sometimes you can slip that transmission off that axle and take it out. But I'll worry about that once we get ready to take the transmission out. So we'll go ahead and take these two bolts out here and see if we can maybe get this axle out. All right, I just about got that off there. It was a little, had to use a little persuasion and a, I have a little pipe wrench here that I kind of stick on my ratchet sometimes. It makes it a little bit easier to break loose because you don't want to wear yourself out. So I've just about got this off. He's going to be on there pretty tight, so you got to just keep putting oil on it and working it back and forth until it just about breaks loose. And I think we just about got it broke loose. And I apologize for my dog next door barking. They leave for days. They don't take care of it, and it'll bark for 8-10 hours a day. It's just sad. Anyway, all right, so now as you can see, I got the nut off, and the tie rod end is still attached. So all I have to do here is take a hammer and hit that and break it loose. And that's the whole secret. A lot of times I'm getting these tie rod end bolts off. Don't break them. Don't hit them first. Take the nut off because it's already seated in there tight, and that'll keep this whole unit there from spinning around on you. And also you can see I've got a couple jacks up under there. I got my big jack, antique jack. I got three jacks under this, and I got my back wheels shocked there, so chalked pretty good on both sides, so it's not going to go anywhere. And now we got to do is go ahead and take this lower ball joint bolt out. This is a 15, I believe it's an 18 on one side and a 15 on the other. I'll let you know that here in a minute. And also these bolts I took out, the brake caliper right there, they're little 10 millimeter bolts. They're pretty easy to take out. And we'll be ready to, just about ready to take this axle out. Also, I almost forgot to tell you, sometimes there's a washer behind this nut here. Don't forget to take it out of the way. Sometimes it has a third washer with bevels, little grooves and bevels in it. So when you put the Carter key in, it keeps it from moving around, but this one didn't have it, so that's just the way it came. So we'll put it back together that way. All right, now let's go ahead and take this lower ball joint bolt off. All right, we got the back nut off on this lower ball joint bolt nut, and that took a 13/16. I had to use a breaker bar on that because it was pretty hard to get out. It was pretty rusty, and there's a look at it. I think you can see it there. And I knocked it back in. And this side, it should be ready to come out. And I recommend that you get a breaker bar. You'll have to have it probably. And you can see how rusty that is. So I had to shoot a little oil on it. And that is out. And like I said, these were 13/16 to get those out. Now all I gotta do is break this tie rod end loose, and I can go ahead and pry down on that lower control arm with my pipe over there and slide that axle out. Then go ahead and slide it out of the transmission. Now that can get a little tricky sometimes. I just get underneath with a pipe up against it and tap on it, and it usually comes out, but we'll see how that goes. But they do make a special tool you can buy that goes in behind that and it'll pop it out. Of course, I don't have it. Maybe someday I'll buy one, I don't know. But we'll see if we can get this axle out. So we'll go ahead now and take this tie rod end off. All right, I had to hit that pretty hard there. I think I got loose. I'm using a big hammer. I had a smaller one right there, but bigger one seemed to help a lot. And they do make a tool you can buy, a tie rod end spreader you can buy, but sometimes this works out pretty good. Let me hit it one more time. Oh, there we go. All right. And always check your tie rod, and when you take it off, make sure it's tight. And yeah, it's tight. It's good shape. No problem there. And check your inner tie rod and kind of move it back and forth. Make sure there's no play. And All I gotta do now is separate the lower ball joint with the pipe and go ahead and start taking that axle out. Now, when I slide this lower control arm down, I should be able to release this ball joint. And what this will do, this will let this whole unit, oh, I'm sorry about this light. This will let this whole top unit swing out, and I can slide this axle out and kind of push this unit off to the side. I should be able to get that axle out of the transmission back in there. So I'll set the camera down. Let me go get a pipe and separate this. All right, I got my pipe in there. A lot of times you just got to figure out what works best to get that lower control arm down, and you can see right there, the lower ball joint is separated. So all you got to do is just kind of push down on it. And actually, it's not, it didn't have to, I didn't have to push down very much on it. So if you just have a small bar, it would probably work. The pipe I'm using is pretty long. I've had it forever. It's about 3 feet long or so. And now all I have to do, if I hold the light, and you can see how this axle already went in. If I pull out, the axle just basically came out just like that. And that's how you would take your axle out of the front of this. So now all we gotta do is go ahead and pop it out. And I'm more than likely we'll get under here with a pipe. And you can see, if you have that special tool, there's a place cut in that axle housing that will allow you to get there and pry on it, and it'll pop that axle out.
Now we're going to go ahead and pop this axle out. Now, what I found out, if you don't have that special tool to get that axle out, just take a regular tire iron like this, and if you get right on the edge of this lip, right back there on where that housing is, I don't know if you can see that, and hold that there, and sometimes just kind of tug on it, push on it, hit it, then that axle will pop out. You don't have to really beat on it or anything, but it usually comes right out. So that worked out pretty good. And now all I gotta do is slide it out on the housing on the other side. And it's a good thing I took out the transmission fluid, because I'd have a shower of transmission fluid right now if I had not done that. By the way, I did take the transmission pan off and drained all the fluid out of it earlier. And so we'll go ahead and pull this axle out. Let me just crawl up here and you can kind of watch me pull this out. And believe it or not, once you get the axle out, the hard part is pretty much done. Everything else, just small bolts and stuff on that transmission, and you got to prep it in order to kind of get it out. And of course, I'll have to set the camera down in order to get this out of here, because I got to lift up on that axle there. So let me lift up on that axle and pull it out of there without damaging the boot. There you go. Oh! And there is the axle. The light on it. Give you a look at it real quick. And what holds that axle is that little clip right there. But if you can get your your tire tool right there on the edge of that lip and kind of pull out on it against the transmission, a little leverage, it usually comes right out. And my axle's in good shape. By the way, this model does not have the ABS anti-lock braking system on it, which some models had, some models did not have it. And at this point, the hard part's done. All I gotta do now is start unbolting transmission bolts. Take some bolts out of the top of the transmission, get that crank seal, crank sensor out of the back out, and get some brackets loose and stuff. Now, I didn't tell you guys this earlier. If you're gonna do this by yourself, I have a transmission jack, which is hiding on me. There's no way I could do this by myself. I've got this transmission jack, and I think I only paid like $80 for it, free shipping. It's been a lifesaver. Now, if you have two buddies that are very strong, maybe two of you can do this, but this is a pretty heavy transmission, so you will need a transmission jack, and if you do mechanical work, it's probably well worth your time to buy one of those. So I'm not doing it and lifting it on my own. I've got some help there with that transmission jack. So now I'll go underneath and we'll start unbolting some bolts and kind of give you an idea what I'm doing here to separate this transmission from the engine. And after taking out a handful of clips now, I've pretty much got the inner fender out here, plastic. And this just makes it a little bit easier. I'll set that over to the other side. a little bit. This makes it easier to get into the transmission. Now you can see the plug there on the transmission that I have to unhook. You can get to it. And there's a bolt right there that holds that motor mount in. I can get into it now, put an extension and a 18 millimeter socket on there. And that transmission will drop out of there once I get everything hooked up. And like I said, everything else now, the hard part's done. I just got to lay under there and start unhooking some transmission bolts, unhook the flywheel, 4 bolts, and some bolts on top and make sure all the little wires and stuff are unhooked, and a couple of transmission lines so I don't break anything. But I'll do a few things here and we'll look at it and kind of keep you up to date on what you have to do to separate or drop this transmission. So I did kind of bungee cord my brakes there, my caliper, up on the coil just so it kind of stays out of the way. No point in unhooking all that stuff. You don't really need to on this. All right, I got the starter off. The trick to this starter is you got 3 bolts on the other side, these 15 millimeter bolts, and you got to take all 3 of them off at the same time because when you're pulling it off, there's a little area here that's kind of tight. If I spin around, right there, when you get your socket up on the top, where the bolt goes, it wants to hit the back of this little transmission housing. So just push the starter forward and just take all 3 bolts out at the same time. And it makes it a lot easier to drop that starter out. Also, you can see where the antifreeze is getting up in the starter. So for you folks who are just watching, I am taking this transmission apart so I can replace a couple of soft plugs in the engine here. It's leaking. So we'll get the starter out and we'll go ahead and continue taking some more stuff apart. All right, now we were talking about the starter earlier. Now what I did on mine from an earlier video, this wire on the back of this starter, that nut will not come off. It's rusted on there pretty bad. But there's nothing wrong with the starter, so I'm not gonna mess with it. So what I did, I just fished it, the wiring harness, fished it down through there and just kind of laid it off to the side. And there's one more wire that goes up to your crank sensor. I could not get that to come loose. Someone has broken the clip there. So I just unbolted it and pulled it out of there. Make sure you pull this out, this whole sensor, before you try to take that transmission out, because this will hang up on the flywheel or whatever as you try to get that loose, and it'll snap this and break it, and you don't want to break that. And this is all laying off to the side. Now I'm going to go under here and show you one other thing. The bracket that was right here, this big old bracket, I just disconnected. It's got some 15 millimeter nuts on it. It's got a long bolt that's right there, which is right here, 13. And once you get this loose, you can let this wiring harness snake down through here with that starter and kind of lay it off to the side, because I didn't really want to bungee cord it here. So I just know, my luck, it'll come down and smack me in the head and I'll lose 5 or 6 teeth. So at this point, all I gotta do is take these bolts out of the front of this right here, this bracket. I've already broken them loose. Take them out and get this big mess here out of the way, because I would rather have this out of the way. I know it's a little more work, but it just makes it a little bit easier. There's one bolt. All right, there's the bracket. I had a video stop. I ran out of memory on my camera. Shooting in high definition takes a lot of memory. So that bracket's out of the way, and you can see I got a lot of room here now. Now, the only thing I have to do is take that bracket off, start and take the torque converter bolts off, which are pretty easy. Now, my cover back here, I had it off from earlier when I replaced the oil pan. I just didn't put it back on because I knew I had this leak and I was going to take this back apart sometime. So that's why the cover wasn't on here. And that cover is pretty easy to take off. Just got a couple small bolts there and you got to snake it out of there. Just a little protector that gets bolted right there over the flywheel. And go up on top, start disconnecting some bolts. And then what I'm going to have to do is block this engine up a little bit, put a block of wood here or something. Because when I go to take that motor mount on the other side of the transmission, this transmission is going to drop down and the motor is going to drop down. And then I should be able to slide the transmission out. And you can see how that axle is setting in there. Some of these transmissions, right here, the problem becomes sometimes with the frame, that transmission will hit the side of this frame, but I have probably 4 inches of room there, so I should be able to pull this transmission off the slide and hopefully let that axle just slide out of there, because this will save an hour's worth of work. I'm hoping I don't have to take that axle out. All right, enough talking. Let me go ahead and take some more stuff apart here and prep this up and get ready to drop it out of here, and we'll look behind the flywheel here and see what we got. And this has got a special flywheel. If you notice right there, it's got places cut in on the back side of it for that crank sensor so it can keep timing. So when I separate this transmission from the flywheel and the torque converter, I have to pull the torque converter out inside of that flywheel there. I have to pull out on it so it doesn't hit the sides of it. But I'll show you that once we get it apart. All right, let's go ahead and take some more things apart here. All right, children of the sun. Yeah, it's a classic rock and roll night, I guess. I've got all my bolts out of the torque converter. Very easy to do. They're right there, kind of sitting. They were, I believe, 18. Make sure you mark your flywheel and put a little paint back there in the hole in the torque converter. That way when you put it back together, if you're using the same torque converter, there's no issue with these bolt holes lining up. Sometimes those bolt holes can get off center and it's kind of a pain in the butt to get it back together. So that's all done there. And let's see, let's go up on top. By the way, this flywheel turns real easy. I just took a screwdriver on the teeth there and spun it. And when I got the bolt up to this position right there, I just put a socket on and broke it loose. Very easy. All right, now let's go up on top. Not as flexible as I used to be. The transmission, I got all my, I did kind of lie. There was a water hose there. I just unhooked it and put it right there. Kind of gave me a little more room. That wiring harness, I put a bungee cord on and pulled it back out of the way so I'd have a lot more room here. I got my plug unhooked on the solenoid pack. Got the two lines unhooked the transmission, and I pulled the dipstick out. And you remember that bolt that was there that I couldn't get loose? Well, basically, I just cut it and twisted until I got the bolt kind of broke off and got it out of there. And there were two wires, there's a couple ground wires that go here that were on it right there. I got the bolt off, and I'm going to put another bolt in the block there for that ground. I got the, the gear shift cable unhooked. It just snaps out of the off of this nipple. It's sitting right here now. I think you can see it there. Got pushed out of the way. Now, I did lie about this tube that goes like this, where the two bolts are for the, hold my light up here. I'm having lots of trouble with my light tonight. That goes underneath the transmission here. There's two bolts that go in the block. Actually, if I could just straighten this up a little bit more, can show you this. There you go. It kind of sits in there like this, and there's two bolts back there. Well, those two bolts are right here. They actually, you have to take this off because those bolts are threaded also into here. It's just kind of bolted on the transmission. The bolts go through it. That's just the way it's set up. And check your O-ring because a lot of these leak. Mine's okay. Someone decided to put some kind of glue on it, but the O-ring is okay. And I'll just kind of push this back out of the way, off to the side. And it's still partially hooked up, so I know how it goes back in. And I've just about got all my transmission bolts out. Like I said, they're right there. Very easy to take out. They're all 18 millimeter. Now on the bottom, a lot of people forget, a lot of guys forget about these bolts down here. There's two down there on that bracket. There's one there, and there's one on this side right about there. It's hidden. See that right there? Don't forget to take those out, because I've forgotten to take those out and the transmission will not come out, and you're wiggling it. You find out that motor mount back there has two bolts on it and they have to come out, and they're right there. Little shorties. And really all I have to do now is stick a jack up under the transmission. And I've got, I believe, one or two bolts underneath that have to come out. And
That's about it. Transmission's ready to be separated. Let's see, one is right. Give my light just right so you can see it. It's right there. Zoom my camera in. It's kind of hidden. It's a 18, and I believe that is it. Let's see. No, I did lie. There's one more right there. That one's got to come out. That's part of that motor mount that I told you about. That some people don't see those three bolts in that motor mount, and they're wiggling that transmission. They can't get it out. Well, you got to make sure you get all three of those bolts out. And that's it. It's ready to come out. So what I have to do is put a jack up under this. Go ahead and get my transmission jack, prep it. And once I do that, the last bolt that comes out is right here. Let's take a deep weld in there and take that out, and that will release it from the motor mount. And I can go ahead and drop this transmission down and separate it and get in there and take the flywheel off and see where my leak is at. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and take those three bolts out that I just showed you, those couple bolts on the bottom. And I got one up here left on the transmission. I just left it in there for safety reasons. Take it out very last. And we'll drop this transmission out. So let's finish up here. Looked pretty good. And I think I did mention I pulled the dipstick out and kind of stuck it over there off to the side. And that's about it. Pretty simple to take out. I know. You're saying it's simple. Yeah. But it's a little work, but it can be done. So let's go ahead and finish up here. All right, I got the two bolts out on the back of the transmission near the mount, and now I am ready to go ahead and start dropping this out. I got my jack set up there. Some blocks of wood always helps, and you can kind of see how it's kind of sitting there with the wood and everything. And I've gone ahead and taken out this bolt that's in the motor mount, transmission mount. The idea is that when I lower this a little bit, there are three other bolts right there. I can get the light there. Once this gets a little lower, I can take those three out, and it'll release that bracket completely. Then this transmission, once I put the jack all the way down on the floor, I should be able to wheel it out of my way. So, we're going to go ahead and lower this down a little bit and see what happens. It looks like it's pretty much right where I want it at this point. And, of course, the light, not so good. All right, try that. Go ahead and lower this down a little bit. And there it comes down. All right, now what I've got to do is go over there and take a screwdriver and block that, I'll take a screwdriver and I'll go ahead and separate the transmission from the engine block. And we'll go ahead and take it out of here. It looks like it's going to be pretty simple. Okay, the transmission is now separated from the engine block, and you can see the flywheel and the torque converter, which is right there. It's pretty far apart, and that axle is way out, so I should be able to get this out without taking that axle out. Now, what I've done, I've lowered it just a little bit on my jack, probably about 3 inches. Now I gotta go back on this side, and we have to take out these three bolts I was telling you earlier, right there, because that motor mount is still partially up in there on that bracket. So once we take these out, I should be able to go ahead and lower this entire transmission out. So let me set the camera down, we'll take these out. All right, there's the bracket, it's out. And you can see that transmission now is pretty much free from the mount on the top there where that bolt goes through. So now all I gotta do is go underneath and we'll lower this down some more. See how far it comes out. And I tell you what, apparently there's a lot of leakage up under there because there's water still dripping. And it's just about out. At this point, I'll take my, and you can see where the axle is. It's just about all the way out. So that's gonna help me out a lot. And at this point, I think all I have to do is go ahead and drop it down, and you can see it's apart on the top of the transmission there. I've just gotta reposition my transmission jack, get it up under there a little farther and wiggle it off that axle and go ahead and lower this down. So let me set the camera down and I'll do this. Just too bad I'm a one-man band. I need to get a tripod set up. All right, well, I'm going to have to slide all the way across the axle there.
And I just kind of wiggled it, and down it comes. Transmission's pretty much out at this point. And that axle is pretty long. But, you know, if I had to do it again, I'd probably just pull the axle out. It might save a little time, but, you know, you can drop a transmission this way. The only reason I didn't pull it out is because I don't have a lot of room in my garage. But if I was outside, I probably would just pull both axles. But transmission's pretty much out. Now, I'm going to slide it off the jack here and get it out of the way. And all I have to do is pop that flywheel off, and I'm excited to see where that leak was. But you can see where it was leaking, it was slinging it back up on the transmission. It was pretty bad. Pretty bad antifreeze leak. So, like I said, this is not a perfect video, but this will give you some idea what you got to do to pull a 3.0 transmission in a caravan or whatever. Alright, well, let's go ahead and see if we get this flywheel off. We'll pull this transmission out of the way. Oh, and one last thing before I pull that flywheel off and we look at where that leak is. I did put a couple blocks up under the engine there. When I lifted the engine back up about 2 inches, it made that transmission come off that flywheel real easy. So, yeah, I did have to block up that block a little bit. I should say that again. I did have to block up the bottom of the engine a little bit. There we go. All right, now we'll go ahead and take out this transmission. Now, to get the transmission out, what I did was I tucked my jack, which is up under there. I lifted the car up another 3 inches, and now I can just roll it out, and out it comes. And I'm telling you, these transmission jacks, they're a lifesaver. You really need to invest in one if you don't have one, if you like to work on cars. And this is a remanufactured transmission. They stuck in it about a year ago. And there is my EGR gasket. I'm glad I saw that. I'm going to set this transmission over here out of the way. And there it is. There's a look at it. There's my paint mark. I'm going to replace these two seals. I have two seals laying over there. And now, the big moment comes when I get up under here in a few minutes. And we're going to pop that off, and we're going to look at that leak, and wow, I already see the leak. Yep, it's definitely a soft plug, so we're going to pop these bolts out of the flywheel here, and we'll look in there, and look at this leak. Looks like we finally get some closure here. All right, now, since the transmission's out of the way, and we're just about ready to wrap this video up, because we're going to know here why it's leaking, you can watch me take all these bolts out. I've already taken one out, but I want to get some paint. I'm going to paint this real quick. I'm a believer in marking stuff. It makes your life a lot easier when you put things back together. And now we'll start taking these out. And to make it a little faster, I'm going to use my impact electric tool here. And these are all 17, by the way. 17 socket for these bolts. Oh, I definitely have to get some Loctite. Put these on. Was it a 17? Yeah, 17 millimeter. Alright, got one left. And it'll reveal what our leak was, where it was, and why it was leaking. Oh, I don't want the fall to hit me in the head. Alrighty, here we go. Let's take this off. Let's see, yeah, make sure I better mark it a little bit better. Never can be too careful. There we go. Always nice to mark things. All right, now we can take the flywheel off and reveal the leak. All right. There's the back of the flywheel. Pretty messy, huh? All right, check it out. If you have a 3.0,
you have that leak, mysterious leak between the transmission and the engine, there you go. You know, for 5 cents, they could have put a nice soft plug in, freeze plug, just like that on that side. And, you know, there just happened to be two, and one would go bad. Unreal. So the entire time, that's what's been leaking. I wonder if I crawl up here a little bit better so you can kind of see this. I'm going to take a screwdriver or something. Apologize if I'm shaking the camera. I'm trying to get set just right. All right, there we go. Wow. Oops. Well, there was the leak. Nice. Well, looks like I'll be buying a freeze plug tomorrow. That's how bad that was. I didn't even, I just barely touched that and knocked the hole in it. So, there you go. So I'll go out tomorrow and I'll buy two, looks like I'm just going to need one. I'll go out and buy a couple freeze plugs. Maybe I'll replace them both, I don't know. And finish it up. So this is the end of this video, this part of this video anyway. But just my luck. Like I said, I have never had an issue with a soft plug or freeze plug rusting out like that. That's nuts. At least my rear main seal's in good shape. I don't see no oil leaks or anything. Alright, so when I get ready to put this back in, I'll make a video and show you guys what it looks like when it's all back together. So that's how you take the transmission out of a 3.0. And hopefully you're not having any issues like I'm having. There's a nice shot of the back of the engine. And as the antifreeze leaks. Alright, well, thanks for watching. I'll wrap it up with the next part 3. And we'll put a couple soft plugs in it and we'll go from there. So thanks for watching. And mystery is solved. Yay!